Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this evening's game of the WePlay League Season 3 Team at Finem versus Wombat Gaming. My name is Dragon Drop. I'm joined by Annie. Annie, how are you doing?
Hey, I'm doing super good. Super excited to be back on WePlay. I always have fun casting with you, and we get to cast Ad Phenom versus Wombat Gaming. This is going to be a fantastic matchup, and you know I'm a Golden Boys fan at heart, but you are German, so you got some national pride on the line.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, AF, you gotta expect them to win here. They're sitting at 8-1 in a tournament. They're even one of the few teams who still have a chance of catching up to Team Liquid, who are sitting at 10-1 and grab that land spot. So, and yeah, if you remember, we play League, $200,000 on the line here in the main event. So getting there would be absolutely huge for AF. But there's still a couple of games left to be played, which makes it all the more important for them to win this one. Wombat Gaming, yeah, you're right. I got to root for my German boys, though, even though they're 1-11 in the tournament, and the only win that they got was a default win against No Logic Gaming. So, well, if you play
yeah,
Seres on Wombat Gaming, you will get a huge payout, I suppose.
Yeah, I mean, they're down, but they're certainly not out. Definitely some strong players. I've seen some clutch plays come out of them before, and, well, you don't want to underestimate them, but... like you mentioned, Ad Phenom, such a strong team right now. They're 18th in the world and 10 in Europe and CIS, which is a really high ranking considering how many great teams come out of that region.
Yeah, absolutely. Of course, Spartan, Madara, Thug maybe next time, and this other guy, I haven't actually seen him before. I don't even know how to say that name. Is it someone else?
I think he's a roster tweak. I'm not sure if he's a permanent member yet, but we'll get to see. Ooh, we got a Chen pickup. I like that a lot.
Oh yeah, Chen first pick, Lone Druid and Invoker both coming through as well, with the Wisp and the Earth Spirit being banned, Bane and OD. Very, very targeted bans from AF, perhaps. I mean, especially Bane, we mostly see that get through. But obviously, very annoying hero to deal with at the very least, but that does of course mean that we see all the other strong heroes in the meta. Yeah, you mentioned the Chen. Now the Vengeful Spirit as well. Well, so far, so standard by the looks of it.
That, I believe, is going to be a carry Vengeful Spirit, unless they decide to draft something funky, but I've seen Madara run carry Venge a lot. I think he's actually run it in this tournament before, and it is so incredibly strong.
It is, yeah. If you manage to run it well, and if you have a hero in the middle lane, or maybe the off lane, that can really benefit from the aura later down the line, that can kind of pick up the one position mantle at some point, being supported by the Vengeful Spirit with the auras, with the really good lockdown actually that you have, just with the frequency that you spam out the stuns, with the low cooldown, and also the kind of tankiness that she has, or that she builds up, especially if she's in the carry role. And not to mention the kind of shenanigans that you can do if you manage to get yourself an Aghanim Scepter and do that all over again, even if the enemy picks you off. So, very strong hero if you can get it off the ground, either as a carry or even as a support, doesn't really matter too much.
Yeah, I mean, just looking at their recent pickups, they haven't picked up Venge as a support, but again, it is a strong support, very good with that stun, with the swap, great teamfight control. I'm loving the Chen pickup here. Chen has an incredibly high win rate this patch, overall in 6.86. He's got a 64.9% win rate in professional Dota, which is pretty high. It's actually the fourth highest win rate overall of any hero, so hopefully Ad Phenom can get him off the ground, but if Wombat Gaming shut him down right from the start, well, he's going to have a tough time having really any effect in teamfights.
Team extra bans coming out, Wombat kind of focusing on the middle lane a bit, banning out the Vipers or the Death Prophet, really wanting to make sure that Invoker gets a good matchup there in that particular lane. I'd find him. Well, they focus on similar kind of things here with the Bounty Hunter, not wanting to have that up against a Chen roaming around or even disturbing the middle lane for themselves, no matter what they end up picking up here. Who do you actually think in terms of mid heroes? Do you go for a Lina or a Queen of Pain, just straight up magic burst that can kind of trade farm with the Invoker?
Yeah, I think, well, obviously OD's banned out, Viper's banned out, and I think that's directly against Thug, who has run Viper mid before. Quap is still in the pool, which I think it could be an alright pickup here. I worry about her survivability up against an Invoker that can kind of tick her down slowly. The cold snap's going to hurt, but I think that could be a possibility. I know Thug feels comfortable with Queen of Pain. Let's see if it gets banned out here.
But now they're going to go for the Beastmaster in the offlane, so already looks like some very strong push, not just coming from the Chen, but also being supplemented by the Beastmaster. We do nowadays see go for the 1-4-4 build. With points into the ultimate, of course, just not really focusing on the axes, just having it for the utility, but really maxing out the Warp and the Hog for the laning stage and vision, and then the attack speed aura to buff up the push, especially if you have so many other units can really benefit from that. So that's something that Wombat Gaming maybe have to
Five
watch out for.
seconds
They do have the
remaining.
Witch Doctor though to kind of try and keep the Chen creeps controlled
joinDOTA.
at the very least.
Yeah, I mean, add Finem right now, going for a pretty heavy summon lineup. They've got all the Chen creeps, they've got the Beastmaster, so add Finem has the potential to really, really push hard before, 25, 30 minutes in the game, maybe even getting down to your threes at that point. Wombat need to pick a defensive hero right here. They've got the lone druid to kind of go off and do his own thing. They've got the witch doctor to help pace the team fights, but they should pick up some sort of hero that's going to benefit from a lot of creeps coming at them really fast.
Question is, who can that be? I mean, if you're looking at carries, maybe look at someone like a Sven, so you have some cleave available to just kind of mop up all these group A's. If you want to go a bit old school, you can even I was gonna suggest a Doom just to eat the creeps, be a little bit cheeky there, but it doesn't really fit into the lineup, especially not against that Finem right now. But they're still looking for a secondary support next to the Witch Doctor.
Well, you bring up Doom. It might not be the worst pick in the world. Rain's run it before. He actually has a pretty all right win rate on Doom, but it's pocket strat. It's not maybe something they want to pick up to try to take Ad Finem out of the tournament unless they've practiced it a lot.
I don't know. I mean, there's some utility to be gained from that ultimate as well, and but unless it's up against someone that really,
Dire
really
team.
carries the team on the back, like a Storm Spirit of old, I feel like the Doom is mostly wasted. And then all you really have is the big tanky guy that right clicks every once in a while, but probably not going to see that anytime soon. Instead, they're going to go for the gyrocopter now. And yeah, of course, he's kind of the obvious choice, right? Not bend out. Has the flak cannon to deal with all the creeps, scales rather well into the late game, and can still
Disruptor.
provide really, really a lot in the laning
Radiant
phase,
team
especially if you
battle.
consider the Witch Doctor as his probably solo lane support up against the Beastmaster. The Beastmaster is not playing carefully enough here, then the Chaos Mage just bounce between him and his Spore, and that's as easy of a setup as it gets for Gyrocopter to come in and
10
finish him off with the
seconds
Rocket
remaining.
Barrage. So gotta watch out for that if you had Finem.
Yeah,
Five
I love this
seconds
disruptor
remaining.
pick here. I think it's going to be fantastic for bringing Wombat back into the fight. They've got the glimpse, they've got the kinetic field to hold him there.
Disruptor.
Then the static storm as a silence is going to be fantastic against Invoker. He can't really invoke his way out of that one. You can't ghost walk your way out of incredible damage coming out from him, but he does need a fair bit of farm if he wants to get the Aghanim Scepter to disable the BKB on the gyrocopter.
Dire team
Think
battle.
Disruptor pick is also just to augment the push a little bit more, even because what are you going to do if a Chen or the Beastmaster chomping away at your towers? Either you let them go, or you try and defend. To do that, you have to
10
teleport
seconds
in some
remaining.
heroes, mostly. But with the Disruptor there, one of them is
Five
just going to get
seconds
sent
remaining.
straight back. So you have to be really, really careful about that as well. It's going to delay your execution.
Team
It's going to
battle.
delay everything
Radiant
that you might want
team
to
pick.
do if you wanted to defend the tower. So, and of course, the threat of being caught in a big ultimate is its own threat in the first place. So yeah, I like that as an aggressive pick to kind of augment their strat, augment the push that they have, just kind of dissuade Wombat Gaming from trying to fight into them.
Absolutely.
Even though they have a Gyrocopter and Invoker who
10
sometimes or
seconds
mostly are
remaining.
very good at that.
Yeah, last pick is going to
5
be, or sorry,
seconds
last ban
remaining.
coming out from Wombat is going to be Razor. Do you think that's anything Ad Finem would have wanted to go for? Or,
Reserve time.
I mean, really, what do Ad Finem need to pick up here? Is this going to
10
be a core
seconds
Venge, or do
remaining.
they still need to pick up their big heavy farmer?
Do you think it's going to be a
5
core Venge
seconds
simply because no one
remaining.
else really would
Dire
be happy
team
going to the
battle.
middle lane up against the Invoker, so they should be picking up another mid hero here. Queen of Pain, as we said, still in the pool. Same for Lina, both do okay against the Invoker. Maybe even the Zeus, if you want to go that way. You can just sit back and spam the Arc Lightning and then scale quite well late into the game. Not too much synergy with the rest of the lineup though, so maybe that's not exactly the play, but Nightstalker also makes it a little bit tricky with the silence
10
being available.
seconds remaining.
Yeah, I really like Wombat's lineup right
Five
here. I think
seconds
they've got
remaining.
incredible push. They've got a nice mix of peaks. Invoker is going to be pretty useful throughout the early and mid game. Gyrocopter able to carry into the late game. Lone Druid able to rat this out to the bitter end. But I'm worried that Wombat's strategy isn't defensive enough. I think Adfinum, they can push early, they can push hard. And what's Wombat going to do if their base is under attack?
Well, not a whole lot apart from trying to hold high ground here with the cask, with the gyrocopter. Yeah, this is Zeus that we're talking about. So he's going to have to watch out for Nightstalker. But outside of that, he should be all right. But yeah, it's going to be at Wombat Gaming to actually take matters into their own hands, I think. Just keep put under pressure and add Finem as early as you can. Keep the Chen down, make sure that he can't do what he wants. That is, find pickoffs and push towers. Then they should be alright, actually. They need to get the Invoker or Gyrocopter into the mid-game, as well as the Lone Druid. They need to find some space for him at some point as well.
Yeah, I mean, controlling the map is going to be a big challenge here, as Adfinum, they've got really high push potential, they've got great kill potential. They are a little bit squishy, aside from, you know, that Beastmaster and Venge. Once she gets some items, she's pretty hard to take down, especially with the Ags. But do you think Wombat are going to be able to just roll over Adfinum, or do you think Adfinum can kind of get what they need and start to really come online towards the mid-game?
It depends on how Wombat Gaming play it. I would really like to see them go aggro, even. I mean, with the Disruptor, it's kind of a weak lane support. You can sort of get away with it, especially with the Chen, who also needs some time to find creeps to actually help out in lane. So if Wombat Gaming really want to commit to the strategy that they've drafted for, they should probably go for an aggressive try lane, try to keep the Venge down. And Venge, as good as Valaine as she technically is, that's why we see her so successful in a support position as well, you can still be shut down very easily if you get caught out for a little bit even, because you're still super, super squishy early on, especially up against the Gyrocopter with Rocket Barrage and these kind of things. So really like to see this kind of playstyle from Wombat Gaming, where they go super aggro, keep AF from getting to a point where they can stabilize. But we'll find out how it goes as the game starts. My name is Dragon Drop. I'm joined by Annie here for this best of one. We play League Season 3, Wombat Gaming, the Germans, up against the guys from Greece at Finem. At Finem. I'm not entirely sure, but hey. let's take a look at a lineup. Starting with Wombat Gaming on the Radiant side. We've got Chill on that offlane Lone Druid. Down in the middle lane, we're going to have Rain playing the Invoker in the bottom lane, so it looks like they want to go defensive. We've got Arya on that one position Gyrocopter. The supports will be Pineapple Fruit standing in here on the Witch Doctor. The Y50 playing the Nightstalker.
Alright, on the side of the Dire, we've got our Golden Boys, Adfinum. We're going to have SSA Spartan playing the Chen. It's going to be this new guy here that I have not seen before, Zivaginster Bev on the Beastmaster. Here over towards the mid lane, we've got Thug playing the Zeus up here in the top. We've got Madara playing the famous Core Vengeful Spirit. And then finally, we've got Maybe Next Time on the Support Disruptor with wings. That's a cool mount.
Yes, indeed. It's armor too, I think. Yeah, they're gonna go get the top rune, one for one rune exchange, by the looks of it here, so nothing else to say. Where are our wards? We see one in the middle lane here on the Radiant side. Just keep Rain safe from any sort of rotations on her channel later down the line. No Dire wards put out just yet, apart from this one in the top lane here, with a sentry even. So really wanting to make sure that the safe lane is doing well for Venge. So yeah, let's actually start talking about the safe lane. You're up against a Lone Druid. All you have is a Disruptor to help you out and try and right-click it away. But it's not really going to be enough, is it?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if they're going to get the bear here. They're actually getting it down pretty low. It could just pop away, but keeping the bear back, making sure Venge gets farm is going to be absolutely crucial here, because Venge, again, she doesn't stack up as well as some of the other really big, beefy carries we're used to seeing. She's very item-dependent, so making sure Madara gets farm needs to be top priority.
Set the bear taking quite a bit of damage here between multiple thunderstorms, but Jill's gonna be able to drag the creep wave back.
Ooh, bottom
get
lane.
Some easy farm. It's fine. What are you talking about? It's fine. He's a boar.
Well,
he had a boar, I guess.
it's no longer with us. It is from the great beyond.
Bible thumb.
Well, in this mid lane, we've got a very even matchup here. Zeus having so much spam damage, getting Invoker down very low, but Rain also has incredible kill potential. He's got his Sunstrike and Forge Spirits ready to go right now.
He's going in very aggressively, just trying to get it off, trying to get a couple of right clicks in. kind of striking fear into Thaxar, but well, that's kind of the power of the Zeus. You can stay back, you can't just rely on your Arc Lightning to get yourself the last decision. You know, this is why we actually see him sitting on top. They've been getting so many procs off on Rain as well in the process. Bottom lane, well, that's the Beast. Master Beast slowed down a little bit, harassed out by these two supports, obviously. Witch Doctor, very good base damage, not really a way for him to trade, especially with Nightstalker also always able to come in, get the slow off, and also the threat from the boar kind of being a target for the casket bounce back, just like this. But Spot making his way down here as well. They will find Pineapple Fruit, but they bring him down with so much burst damage. Hello.
I could feel the panic from him right there, being like, uh-oh, gotta TP right now, and he just kind of watched his own death happen from third person, but either way, that's going to be first blood. It's not the most important kill possible. Getting out the Witch Doctor is not ideal, but it certainly helps.
Yep. Let's make sure that they're going to be a little bit on their toes. Ooh. Maybe not those. Oh well, that's a little bit too aggressive there from Beastmaster coming in there with no creep support. So Aya got a good amount of Rocket Barrage damage off. Another slow comes out. Keep Aya in range. So that's a kill going the other way this time around. This is not on the support. That's a carry who gets it, which is kind of making up for that first blood earlier. Yeah, Spartan. He's taking over the Rain inside jungle, which I actually like. I mean, not a whole lot that he can really do up against Chill anyway, because he's going to have the Spirit Bear ahead of him scouting. So instead of just put on pressure down here, he's going to have to deal with the cast though. Now he's the one being slowed down by Y50. Sunstrike comes in just a bit off the mark. As Nightstalker unable to keep the chase going, as it is still daytime. If that was a minute later, though, Spartan would have died for sure.
Yeah, up here in the top lane, we haven't talked a whole lot about how the Lone Druid's doing. He's actually doing alright. He's getting up to wave, he's getting a lot of last hits with his bear, but this bear, very, very low, needs to make sure he doesn't give that 300 gold over to the Vengeful Spirit.
Yeah, he can resummon it, though, and that's exactly what he's gonna do now, but yeah, I mean, what's the disruptor gonna do? I mean, sure, you can harass a little bit, but that's two heroes up against you. You can't harass both of them out, essentially. Indeed, snagging some last hits here at the pull. So, yeah, he's getting his levels. At the same time, Beastmaster, well, he's level 4 as well. So, in that department, they're kind of even, if not ahead on the dire side.
Ooh, Zeus is gonna go grab an Invis rune in the bottle.
Probably won't be able to do much with that, and now it's nighttime. He's actually going through the river. Kind of dangerous here if the Nightstalker's right next to you, but don't decide to make play happen. Meanwhile, bottom lane, a little bit of group up perhaps, once again, with Spartan not being dissuaded from his aggressive jungling here. And I think this is going to be the big difference maker here, that just having that extra farm available to you. Especially also taking it back from Wombat Gaming, just making sure that it is in a raid inside jungle, just prevent stacks, prevent extra farm going the way of Aya a little bit later. Yeah,
this bottom lane, we've got a bunch of things going around. We've got a whole Chen army walking through. We've got Beastmaster summons as well. So the Dire, no shortage of little units there, but can they really get anything out of it? This tri lane from the Radiant's proving really effective. So far, they've only lost the Witch Doctor, and Gyrocopter's doing a great job keeping up with farm.
Oh, Nightstalker almost level 4. They're going to smoke up right the hell now together with the Witch Doctor. Making a play for middle lane, perhaps a stuck, well, maybe a little bit too comfortable. Setting at 26 last hits. Rain has since eclipsed it, just by a little bit. But can they actually find a thug here? I'm not sure they can, unless he wants to go a little bit too much forward. But they should get the Void off as he goes into the river for some reason. Sunstrike not gonna latch, thanks to the cast bouncing back, but gonna be happy with that. Cold Snap makes sure they cannot get an extra spell off, even if he wanted to. Yeah, it's about as clean a pickoff as you can get.
Yeah, he just gets absolutely demolished, but when he comes up, he does have his ult ready to go. I'll have enough mana to cast it, so well, in the meantime, if Wombat Gaming get low, they gotta be a little bit careful.
Well, Y15 on top. Got us level 4 off of that, so 2 points into a Hunter in the night. A little bit of extra speed. Down here, Spartan, he finds Pineapple Grapefruit. Aya's there as well, though, with a Rock Barrage. Getting a lot of damage off on this Chen. Couple of right clicks will do the trick to finish him off, and yeah, of course, if your creeps are being stunned up by, oh god, Pineapple Fruit, well, he will be bursted down. That's a little creep control there now. Oh wow, they get him with the ultimate. Didn't quite think it was enough.
Ooh,
damage,
lane.
But top lane, Sunstrike comes out. Hitting on Madari, a couple of right clicks from the bear. Not enough to bring him down just yet. They have to retreat with the TPs coming in. Chill with the Savage Draw and keeping maybe next time away from him. Madari though, still alive. Y50, not so much. And now the glimpse back in range. Oh, Chill has another bear. We'll have to use it. Just try and keep maybe next time away. Goes for another kinetic field. Actually gets it here, but Madara going in a little bit too greedily. Pineapple Fruit made his rotation. Now they're going to look for maybe next time another Sunstrike. Will latch! And a Fairy Fire, not enough to save him from dying here. So Witch Doctor did get that last right click in.
Yeah, Y50 is back there.
They want to keep going here. Spartan is not careful. He's going to be dived. Will be dove right now. There he is. There's a slow, he doesn't have any creeps to protect him. That should be a pretty easy kill. Unless there's TP rotations, there it is, two of those. Maybe next time coming in with another connected field, keeping them there. But Pineapple Fruit with a cast, beautiful cast in between those two. Gildo on the rag side, kind of being right clicked down by Madara, kept the vision with the disruptor. Glimpses back Y50, just trying to keep them away, isolating him from Pineapple Fruit, who's now being right clicked down by this core avenge. That's another kill going the way of Adfinom here.
Yeah, I mean, I think the positive side of that is the glimpse back onto the Disruptor actually, or sorry, onto the Nightstalker actually brought him out of the fight and made sure he lived, whereas, you know, before he could have started taking tower aggro and died. So, I mean, Nightstalker's doing pretty great. 1-1 and 2 at this point has the Iron Talon, has about 200 gold in the bank to pick up a nice shiny item, and he can go in and continue to gank.
He can do that, but it is about to be daytime. He's not quite level 6 yet. There's Swap? What's that Swap? I don't know what that was, but yeah, it is daytime now, so Y50 will just hunt the creeps instead, but it looks good. And it's another thing with the Iron Talon, it's actually super useful up against Chen, just being able to chew through these creeps a little bit quicker, especially this early in the game.
Absolutely. Taking a look at the net worth breakdown, we've got Invoker and Gyrocopter topping the board for right now. Invoker, certainly explainable, those Sunstrike kills have been pretty awesome to watch, or the Sunstrike assists, rather. And Gyrocopter's been keeping himself busy here in the bottom lane. He hasn't really left it, hasn't done a whole lot of ganking, just focusing on those creeps. Do you think that Adfinom needs to start prioritizing Gyrocopter?
I think they should within the next couple of minutes here. They need to get the Chen army back up and running again, and need to start pushing towers. And one of those towers will have to be the bottom lane instead. Gonna go for smoke for the time being. They do have the level 7 on the Beastmaster, so the Roar available together with the damage from the Zeus. They will find the Witch Doctor instead, so maybe can tank the gank a little bit, but Aya not out of the woods yet. Gonna come in, cut through the trees, and there should be Roar coming out right the hell now. They burst down the Witch Doctor immediately, nothing to really help, but now a couple of right clicks come out, not just from his summons here, but also from the Necrobox that he has. And that together with the burst damage from the Zeus, more than enough damage to begin down middle lane. There's another fight here, helped out by the Zeus ultimate. Rain, first one to fall, glimpse back on Y50. Still not keeping him in the kinetic field though, so he should be able to run out. That being said though, it is daytime. Madara gets a stun off. Easy kill. 4 points
MVP
up into that.
Not
burst. Yeah, that brought him low enough to be sniped off by the magic missile, absolutely.
Yeah, I'm really enjoying this global strat here from Adfinom. They've got the Zeus ultimate, they've got the Chen heal, and, well, the summons are doing a fantastic job of being all over the map in the right place. Chen knows how to micro, clearly, and now Beastmaster's got his necros. He might actually pay the price here. Gonna be losing his boar in the bottom lane. Oh, yeah, it goes down.
30 gold going the way of Aya. Definitely needs every scrap gold that he can, considering how well AF is doing so far. It's not like Wombat Gaming aren't getting any kills with a Night Stalker, but they're also giving up a whole lot, which is not exactly the kind of traits you want to take if you have this kind of a lineup.
Yeah, on the net worth breakdown, Madara is actually topping the charts right now, has a completed drum in the stash, going to be waiting to fly that out, and putting some pressure here on the top tower. Meanwhile, bottom lane.
They want to defend this here. Yeah, TP's coming in, maybe next time with a glimpse back into the Static Storm. Rain on top of the Roar, they really want to bring him down. Should be able to here with the last couple of right clicks here. The creeps almost bring down maybe next time, but now Aya, he's a little bit of trouble himself. He doesn't have any mana left to play with thanks to the Necro Creeps. Y50 though, well, will be enough to get the trade, but plenty of minions left to bring down that Gyrocopter. Now Y50 does get the nighttime off, but the kinetic field will land with the slowdown and all the damage from the creeps.
Satyr Tormentor, another fantastic help out right there.
It's also the Mud Golem stun there. Is that another fight going on? I don't know. Pineapple Fruit just ends up dying in the mid lane.
Top lane, Madara.
Oh, God.
Gets an immediate kill there on Lone Druid. Really nice use of the swap stun combo. Doesn't even have a drum in the inventory yet, but already raking in those kills.
Alright, so 3 kills down on the bottom lane. They do get the tower. They get a solo kill in mid and top. This is just falling apart for Wombat Gaming here. This should never be happening. But... well, it is, and now Chen has his 4 creeps. Not exactly the standard ganking creeps. I mean, of course, you have to stun from Mud Golem, but apart from that... well, he's making the setups work for them here with the Shockwave.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that Seder Tormentor is like 2-0 at this point.
At least 2 assists, for sure.
Yeah, well, we are going to see Chen just continue to go around. Is he going to try to take a Roche here? He's got a whole army ready to go and... well, I think that's the plan. He's going to be sacrificing some of his little creep buddies to tank it.
He's going to get some help from the Beastmaster here. 2 points up into the inner beast. Definitely help, of course. He could also use the Vengeful Spur with Madara at back and base, teleporting middle to the middle lane. So he wants to pick that up. Wombat Gaming, if they know what's going on, they don't want to react to it. That they're just taking what they can off the map, which is a tier 1 on top lane. Mid lane here is still being controlled by Thug, so that's not gonna happen. Yeah, it's a really quick Roshan, really early as well, as you can do with the Chen creeps, all the rest of your summons, the Inner Beast aura, and obviously 3 points up into the Vengeance aura as well. The smoke up goes straight for the mid tier 2, I suppose. They can't gank him. Can't kill gank a tier 2, it's not how it works, but they can bring down the tier 1 at the very least.
We did miss an important casualty on the Dire. The 2-0 Seder Tormentor unfortunately met their death. But no. In the top lane, we are going to have some pressure here on the tier 2. I think Dire should get back and try to defend that. We've got the Forge Spirits up, and finally we're going to see rotation here from the Zeus.
Well, they did opt to defend the tier, but they're still putting on some pressure here in this tier 2, forcing WG back at the same time. While they're trying to chase it here, they get the vision with the Zeus ult. They just have to get a little bit closer. There's a haste on Thug. Might actually find Rain, but they need the Beastmaster to get in range too for Roar, but might actually be able to. Rain not all that fast, and they're trying to TP out. That's not gonna work. He's gonna end up falling here with the Glimpse and the Roar. No way for the poor Invoker to go. And now, well, Spartan Madara might even be able to catch someone else who gets in range for a swap or a stun. There it is, the swap back onto Pineapple Fruit. Easy burst down between the Thunderbolt as well as the Magic Missile.
Yeah, yep. Adfinum looks like they might be starting to run away with this game. Yeah, their tier 2 took a little bit of chip damage, but they went in, got 2 important kills, taking out the Witch Doctor as well as the Key Invoker. They still have an Aegis, and now Chen picks up a Mechanism at 14 minutes in the game, so he's definitely doing his job.
Chen's Magbench almost has that Helm of the Dominator. Now they're rotating towards middle lane. Aya will get cornered up and now stunned up under the tower. Madara, though, will fall, but it's only the Aegis for the time being. Madara, well... he's a little bit of help. The Static Storm combo will miss. He gets a glimpse back on the wrong side of it. Chill, but still end up dying to all the creeps being teleported in from Spartan though. So it's 2 heroes going down. The end of it all for Justin Aegis here. So good usage of that. Pineapple Fruit, he wants to go for it. Gets a cast as well as the ultimate maybe next time. But, well, there was no Maledict. So he will survive. God, what's going on here? Well, that's the Beastmaster going down at the very least. So Y50 in rain. Being able to bring him down here between nighttime prowess with the Nightstalker and the Cold Snapper. Same time, there's still a big bunch of angry heroes here on the side of Bad Finem. Want to see some blood. Y50 and Rain, they're being spotted out by Zeus ult, but the tower falls. Madara being controlled up for the time being, but this is the wrong way to go. This is not the base. He's being glimpsed back towards it, but unfortunately also towards an army of creeps and a lot of bursts from the Zeus, so... Y50 able to teleport out, but losing the Invoker again, this is not what you want to have happen here if you're Wombat Gaming.
Yeah, this Invoker cannot keep dying like this. His item build is a little bit curious. I think it's out of desperation, mostly. Handomite is fine. I've seen him go first item Handomite, but he doesn't opt to finish the Yules. Instead, just goes straight for the Blink Dagger. He needs that mobility.
Yep. Needs the mobility. They need the initiation as well. Now, glimpse back on Y50. Keeping them away. Aya's still on the hunt here. Spartan maybe in a bad position. Has the creeps though, but that will only work against him here. The cast bounces back. Not the case here. Gets the healer, but Aya right on top of him here with the right clicks. It's gonna be enough though. Another healer from the mechanism. Keeps WG in here for a while. Now the roll onto Aya. Want to bring him down. 2 men. Well, not exactly 2 men. Static Storm, but at the very least it keeps Y50 unable to help out. Another glimpse back here into the loving arms of the creeps. A couple of right clicks should do the trick here. Thug silenced up. But it didn't even need to use any of his spells to finish off that Nightstalker. So that's a Shen for your core hero and the support team.
Ooh,
Dargo
hold on,
actually being
Rain.
caught alone. Rain, well, just needs to get a couple of extra spells. It takes so much damage from Madara, who's reasonably tanky at this point, but now Cold Snap, a couple of rockets coming in, but hey, here's the reinforcements. They have to run out the swap back, keep it getting chill in a little bit further. Rain dies to all the birth of the Zeus. And so does the Lone Druid here. Beastmaster picking it up with his own summon. So action all across the map. 10 to 25. Not even 17 minutes into the game. Annie, what do you think?
I think we are really seeing the power of Ad Venom's draft. They're applying pressure in every different lane at once. They've got some global abilities, that Hand of God keeping everyone healthy. Obviously, Zeus ult can just do incredible amounts of damage at this
Y50
point.
Y50 is dead. He's
yeah,
dead. Swap back, stun. Zeus, well, using a bit of mana.
Yeah, he's out of there. Madara is now top of the net worth chart. In fact, the top three heroes in the net
oh,
worth
hang on.
Chart.
Top lane, maybe next time. Well, should be Daffy, perhaps. Maybe not just yet. Pineapple Fruit is getting it in. Sunstrike will miss, but they finally bring him down. But almost survived that with a glimpse back on Aya. But yeah, at
yeah,
what
and
cost?
Look how many resources it took just to get the support disruptor down.
Yeah.
He's the lowest net worth on Ad Venom, and it took Gyrocopter rotating in, it took an Invoker Sunstrike, it took Witch Doctors, all of his abilities, so... I mean, yeah, you get the Disruptor, but how much space was made by that? Now the Tier 2 is down in the bottom lane, and it looks like Advina might be ready to push high ground.
They certainly could here, maybe they just want to hold on until they have all the ultimates at the ready. Zeus is gonna get his back in a couple of seconds. Same time, they have a bunch of creeps and Necro level 3 freshly summoned. Look at this, tier 3 almost down already with just a couple of seconds of them banging away at it.
The Seder
Look
for
the latest for time being, and yeah. That poor Seder, the hero of this game, but...
That's my
today.
MVP right there.
Well, top tower's being traded out by creeps for the time being. That's also a reaction to the release. So, Wombat Gaming still holding on, but how long can they hold on?
I don't know, it's starting to feel like Ad Phenom, they're just circling around him and tightening the noose at this point. All the outer towers are down except for this mid tower, which, you know, as soon as the units go on that, that is just gonna melt down completely. Madara is just getting bigger and bigger, going for that Sanj and Yasha almost has it completed, and, well, the Helm of the Dominator is certainly helping things out as well. We're gonna have a fight here, though.
Yeah, they want to find something, you need to find something. Get the cast off pretty decently if it can bounce back between Thug, and maybe next time it does get his ultimate off. That means a WG, they can't really chase Y50, being controlled up. Fire Chain creeps here, no one really died, this is Death Ward. Doing a bit of damage here along with the Meatball, but this is just gonna be healed up by Spartan. And now, turnaround here, Chill has to keep the Beastmaster away from him with the Savage Roar, but an actual Roar might come out still here. Thug blinking in, the gets vision for the glimpse back, and that's Chill going down. Even swap back on Rain, not even content on getting one kill, make it two. Make it 3 in total here, and that's a dead tier 2, a dead tier 3 as well. There's no buyback on the bear or the invoker.
Yeah, this is looking really, really grim for Wombat Gaming. I don't know if we've looked at the overall XP and net worth charts, but we are tipping over 12,000 XP, over 10,000 net worth. It seems like Ad Phenom are just running away with this, and I don't see a Wombat Gaming get back in it anytime soon.
Going straight for the bottom lane here with the tier 3 already being weakened. Want to get the most out of these 2-3 kills that they got a moment ago. And yeah, with the kind of push lineup that they have, these racks don't stand a chance here. A couple of extra right clicks, the middle racks are down. They can get the hell out of here now. Leave the range racks for the time being, which is the safe thing to do. But it is nighttime. Y50 trying to go for it, but there's the roar back. He's just getting blown up here. Now, nice little swap back. Madara. He's kind of all left alone though. The rest of his team trying to help him out, but look at it. It was a bait. 3 heroes in a static storm, plus Zeus. So much lightning, and that's a full 5-man wipe. With a simple sacrifice of the one position Vengeful's bird. Everyone is dead. That's dead range racks. They still have a decent amount of creeps here. They should have a. Don't have another set of necro minions though. But 4
Ooh,
buybacks for us now. Alright, maybe next time. You should be falling to that, but it's not exactly worth it.
That is absolutely that last stand effort here by Wombat Gaming to get back in it, and, well, it's gonna be called out in all chat that that was just such a feisty move. It does force Ad Phenom back, and looks like they're gonna get out safely. They do sacrifice their Disruptor. Ooh, Thug here in some trouble.
They can get this kill, and they should really be able to. He doesn't have any support coming with the Cold Snap, with everything that they have. They do bring down That Zeus Invoker picking up that unstoppable streak. Definitely a very welcome infusion of money, but even with that, he's below the Disruptor on the side of AF. Disruptor has a mind of his own, by the way.
The breakdown of net worth is kind of insane. Yeah, Disruptor, he's having a fantastic game here. The Aetherlens certainly helping things out, glimpsing people back from a zillion miles away.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, we're in Europe. Kilometers.
Thank you.
Anyway, here we're going to have a run in here as Y50 just gets creamed down by the Beastmaster. He tries to Glimmer Cape to get himself out. Now Pineapple Fruit's here. There's going to be a call down forcing the Beastmaster back. Pineapple Fruit going in with the Death Ward immediately cancels it here as Madara here to start things off. And there's going to be a swap.
Swap back on Aya. Do get the stun. Even the glimpse back in Pineapple Fruit. Just saving him for later at this point with the kinetic field as well. Warspirit trying to come in. The Bear with the Savage Roar just trying desperately to keep them safe, keep AF away from the heroes, but still, the point stands. Gyrocopter's dead again. The Bear, well, just leave him for food at this stage. And it's another push mounting. AF, they have the full lineup here. They have another creeper for a couple of seconds. And this could be it. This could be it right now. I'm calling it. Are you calling it, Annie?
I mean, I think it's been over for a little bit. I think this might just be the final push from Adfinem. We're gonna see a glimpse, we're gonna see a kinetic field. Y50 just gonna get melted down. He's walking around waiting for death. Didn't even try to get anything out of that. Pineapple Fruit just trying to get back to base. He'll get chunked down, and Invoker gonna be scrambling for the safety of his fountain as Adfinem just slowly melt down the rest of the base.
Oh, the BM is real. Oh,
oh no.
Well, maybe next time we'll die for sins. Thugno has himself and own Ghost Scepter. So at least they have fun, right? At least they have fun.
Yeah, GG will these play two teams have a lot of respect for each other. We're dropping items on the ground. We've got so many freaking summons, my goodness. And the courier's out of the base, too, so that's how you know it's over. But overall, yeah, Adfinem take a very convincing victory.
Well, definitely expected. It was a fun game at the very least, just when it comes to kill count here. Adfinem, they definitely delivered 13-3-11 on the Beastmaster, 8-3-21 on the Zeus. Madara also with 8 kills on that Vengeful Spirit. So, yeah, it was a fun game for sure. But that puts Adfinem at 9-1, I want to say. 1 win away from tying up with Team Liquid, of course. From Team Liquid in the top spot of this particular group, of course. Both teams still have a couple of games left to be played. There's 14 points in total that you have to gather, and only the winner gets to come to the LAN finals. So still some ways to go for these teams, but that will all continue after the major, I believe. So hey.
Yeah, well, definitely a pleasure to watch. Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, thanks for joining me as always, Annie. So yeah, where can I find you? I guess this is the time for shameless plugs again.
All right, shameless plugs, that's the best. If you enjoyed my casting or just want to give me feedback, I'd absolutely love to hear any way that I can improve and, you know, get better at casting, because this is what I love. You can follow me on Twitter at Android, AnneeDroid. It's right up there in the title of the broadcast. And yeah, feel free to let me know what you think. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, go ahead and do that. While you're already at it, you can also follow me at DragAndDropDota. And you can also head on over to joindota.com, check out the coverage page for the WePlay League Season 3 to see all the standings and the entire schedule as much as we can keep it up to date. We're trying to do that. It's a little bit on fritz most of the time, but hey. Next game today will be Enemy GG versus Elite Wolves. That'll be happening 12:30 Central European time. It'll be Llama Down Under bringing you that one. So with that, for me and Annie, thank you very much for watching, and see you next time.